Hello, and welcome to the Banker's Tech Talk video series, looking at all things FinTech. We're now in our sixth year of filming, so you can watch all previous episodes on thebanker.com. I'm Joy Macknight, Managing Editor of The Banker, and I'm joined by Rolands Mesters, who is co-founder and CEO of Nordigen, which is an open banking, open API, application programming interfaces platform. Rolands, thanks so much for joining me.
Thanks, Joy. Happy to be here.
So, Rolands, how would you say that the COVID pandemic has really sort of accelerated and maybe transformed the potential of open banking today?
Open banking is quite interesting. It was a hot topic even before COVID hit. And now clearly COVID has accelerated all things digital, including open banking. Open banking is definitely something that allows people more freedom with their banking data. And that freedom is very important in an age where a lot of services have now become digital. So what we're seeing is that the number of institutions who are now licensed and allowed to connect to those open APIs, they've almost doubled in the last year. More than 400 institutions now in Europe allowed to do that. And also, you know, it's been announced that more than 2 million people in UK have already used open banking. So the uptake is pretty significant.
Yeah, I was going to mention that because the open banking implementation entity launched released its figures in terms of the uptake of open banking in the UK on the third anniversary of its launch. But what would you say is the state of play for open banking today?
Open banking is live in UK and in Europe. So that's the good news. But it's also still a bit of a mess. So the largest banks have created those open APIs, meaning that businesses can connect to those APIs and people can now migrate their banking data from one place to the other, and they can do payments in more ways than they are used to. But for businesses, it's still a bit of a problem. It's not simple. It's not, you know, easy to adopt open banking. It's not cheap. I think what we're seeing is that the most tech-savvy companies are using open banking as a way to be in the forefront and to innovate. And they are kind of also paving the way for everyone else. But I think we're only seeing the early adopters still going into the open banking. It's not the early majority just yet.
And how would you say that open banking can really benefit the incumbents for one, but the fintechs or third-party providers for another, but then also, you know, at the end of the day, the end consumer?
Open banking has allowed now new businesses to be created and new services to be done. For example, Europe has a pretty big problem with trust data, identity data, credit histories. There's no pan-European identity verification platform. There's no pan-European credit bureau, and we can see that from the early adopters of open banking. Those are companies that need to be able to identify someone's credit worthiness in a digital space. And so I think that is where a lot of businesses today are, you know, that's how they're using the open banking. And also this is very beneficial to the end users because the more businesses are able to identify credit worthiness of someone, the more inclusive the system becomes. And financial inclusion, of course, is, you know, super, super important.
And why does Nordigen offer free open banking connectivity right now?
The thing about open banking regulation is that, well, open banking in Europe is free. In fact, the regulators have enforced a regulation that says that banks are supposed to create open APIs that are accessible by literally anyone who's licensed to do that. So it is free. The problem is that it's actually not free just yet. And the open banking platforms that exist today in Europe, they're charging money for businesses to access the banking data. For starters, we thought it's not fair, but we also found ways to build very low cost solutions that we figured out how to finance through freemium services on top. And so that's how we ended up building the first free open API for Europe.
Where would you see the biggest growth coming from in future?
Open banking now is picking up in places where it's needed the most. And like I said, credit data is a pretty big problem. There's a big thin file problem in Europe. A lot of companies just don't understand the credit worthiness of their potential customers, which is where open banking fits in very nicely. I think it'll take a while for most businesses to adopt open banking for that use case, but other use cases that we've seen are also coming into play. For example, it's not just the financial services that are adopting open banking. We've seen adoption coming in also from the real estate sector, where companies are using open banking to understand the creditworthiness of their tenants. We've seen this also pick up in other places like the energy sector, where, you know, similarly, open banking has been used to replace the missing credit data. And then there's also other use cases around financial education. We still don't have a pan-European solution for helping people plan their budget. And United States, for, you know, in comparison, has had those kind of solutions for the last more than 10 years, really. So I think we'll also see an explosion in that space, where there will be apps that allow people to understand their true financial health and to make financial decisions much better. So those, I think, you know, would be just a couple of examples of open banking can be useful.
Well, thank you so much for your insights, Rolands.
Yeah, thank you so much.